Hi everyone, in this video I will show you two new features available in Microsoft Lists. The first allows you now to deal and use the attachments field in the new form experience. Moreover, in the second feature, we will see that you can set now a start date and end date when your form will be accessible by the end users. Alright, let me show you every step in this tutorial. Let's go. Here I am in Microsoft Lists and I have my Asset Manager list. So let me click in the command bar on Forms, and here I'm going to edit this Asset Manager form. So I have here the column, in this case Image, and this is available. Moreover, going at the very bottom, I can add a new field, and this one now is the attachments. This is fully supported now. Now, another addition that we have in Microsoft Lists is in settings, the ability to set a start date and an end date when this form can be filled out. So in my case, I'm going to set tomorrow as a start date, and then on Friday, okay, would be the end date. Now, changes are saved, and I can click on Send Form to copy the link. And now, let me open another tab. Let me jump on this new tab, and let me open the link. I cannot access to the form because, of course, I am out from the time range. So what I have to do, I have to change and readapt the start date and end date to be able to fill out this form. So let me do this by setting 12 November. Again, this is going to be saved. Let's go on Send Form. And here again, I'm going to paste the link and return. And I have now my form available here. I have all fields that we have seen before available. I can add an image if I want, and I can add an attachment. So for example, this image, this gorgeous image, I would say. And then let's click on Submit to submit the form. Of course, I need to add the mandatory fields, but this is now the new experience with these two new additions. We have seen two new additions in Microsoft Lists that makes the user experience better. If you enjoyed this video, please consider to subscribe, like, add a comment down below. Let me know if you are going to use the new forms experience in Microsoft Lists or SharePoint Lists. I hope to see you next time.